Friends, today I am going to explain these topics: market analysis, demand analysis, steps in market and demand analysis, and identifying investment opportunities. Let's start from the market analysis. The market demand is the sum of individual demands for a product at a price per unit of time, the quantity demand of a commodity by an individual per unit of time at a given price is known as individual demand for that commodity. The aggregate of individual demands for a product is called market demand for the product. Thus, the total quantity that all the consumers or users of a commodity are willing to buy per unit of time at a given price, all other things remaining the same, is called market demand for that product. The market demand for a product is the analysis of total demand for a firm's product plays a important role in business decision making. Next is demand analysis. The demand of a product means how many customers in the market actually want to use that product. There are a large number of factors that have a direct impact on the demand of a product. So demand analysis means the study of those factors which influence the demand of a product. One can also forecast demand on the basis of information given about these factors. Under demand analysis, we study the elasticity of demand and methods of its measurements, sale forecast and different methods to forecast sales or demand, manipulating demand and appropriate change in allocation or resources. Analysis of demand enables the producer to adjust his production to the demand to maximize the objective functions. Some objectives like to study and analyze the determinants of demand, to measure the elasticity of demand, to prepare sales or demand forecast. Next is steps in market and demand analysis. Market and demand analysis is very important for the success of the future project. It is but essential that it should be carried out in an orderly and systematic manner. So first one is specification of objectives. Objectives are generally structured in the form of questions. For example, who are the consumers? People who can be counted as potential consumers are divided into three categories: people who need or want the products or services, people who are able to buy the goods or service, people who are willing to buy the goods or services. Second one is how many consumers are there, what do they want, next what do they want it, then what quality of desirable, how do they want it, how much can they spend, what price is acceptable. The acceptable price is a function of many considerations such as quality, service, competition, uniqueness, cost of production, perishability, and in how much can they spend. The research should determine total market annual spending, territory market annual spending. Second one is collection of market information. Secondary data, which is readily and economically available, is very useful for market and demand analysis, but often does not provide a comprehensive basis for such analysis and needs to be supplemented with primary data. So, the data collected in market survey may relate to one or more of the following information. First one is motives for purchase, incomes and price elasticity of demand, demand in different segments of the market, total market demand and rate of growth of demand, purchasing plans and intentions, unsatisfied demand, attitudes towards various products and services, distributive trade practices and preferences, socio-economic characteristics of buyers. So, this is the data collected in market survey. Next one is demand forecasting. Demand is considered the basis of the entire process of economic development. Hence, demand plays an important role in the economic social and political fields. So the demand for any commodity is the relationship between the price and the quantity that will be purchased at that price. Characteristics of demand. Demand is an effective desire. It is related with price. It is related with time. There are three types of demand. Price, first one is price demand, second one is income demand, and third one is cross demand. Next one is classification of markets. Classifications of market. So classification of market. Market is what? Any area over which buyers and sellers are in such close touch with one another that the prices obtainable in one part of the market affect the prices paid in other parts is called market. Or a market is a body of persons in such commercial relations that each can easily acquaint himself with the rates at which certain kinds of exchange of goods and services are from time to time made by the other. Characteristics of a market: one reason, one commodity, buyers and sellers, one price, perfect competition. Then classification of markets. Markets can be classified in five categories on the basis of reason, time, competition, work and justification. So on the basis of area, local market, regional market, national market and international market. And on the basis of time, very short period time, short period market, long period market and very long period market or secular market. On the basis of competition, perfect market, imperfect market. On the basis of function, mixed or general market, specialized market, marketing by grades, marketing by samples. On the basis of legality, open or fair market, black market. So this is the classification of market. Next one is identifying investment opportunities. So there are several useful tools or frameworks that are helpful in identifying promising investment opportunities. The more popular ones are the Porter model, life cycle approach and experience curve. So in Porter model, you can see the chart also. This is Porter's five forces model. You can see here bargaining power of supplier, threat of new entrants, threat of substitutes, bargaining power of buyers and industry revenue. So Porter has argued that the profit potential of an industry depends on the combined strength of the following five basic competitive forces. That is, threat of new entrants, rivalry among existing firms, pressure from substitute products, bargaining power of buyers, bargaining power of suppliers. So new entrants, like, it add capacity, inflate cost, push prices down and reduce profitability. Economies of scale are enjoyed by the industry and the government policy limits or even prevents new entrants. Then rivalry between existing firms. Firms in an industry compete on the basis of price, quality, promotion, service, warranties and so on. Then pressure from substitute products. In a way, all firms in an industry face competition from industries producing substitute products. Like when the price performance trade-off offered by the substitute product is attractive, the switching cost for prospective buyers are minimal. Then bargaining power of buyers. Buyers are a competitive force. They can bargain for a price cut, ask for superior quality and better service, and induce rivalry among competitors. So the bargaining power of a buyer group is high when its purchases are large relative to the sales of the seller. Its switching costs are low. It poses a strong threat of backward integration. Next one is bargaining power of suppliers. Suppliers like buyers can exert a competitive force in an industry as they can raise prices, lower quality, and curtail the range of free services that they provide. So, suppliers have strong bargaining power when a few suppliers dominate and the supplier group is more concentrated than the buyer group. They are hardly any viable substitutes for the product supply. The switching costs for the buyers are high. So, these are the investment opportunities, which is portal 5 forces model. Bargaining power of supplier, threat of new entrants, threat of substitutes, bargaining power of buyers. So this is all about the what investment opportunities. Thank you for watching.